walk into this room at your own risk. This is not a new world. It is simply an extension of what began in the old one. It has patterned itself after every dictator who has ever planted the ripping imprint of a boot on the pages of history since the beginning of time. It has refinements, technological advances, and a more sophisticated approach to the destruction of human freedom. But like every one of the super states that preceded it, it has one iron rule. Logic is an enemy and truth is a menace. And like some goose-stepping predecessors, he searches for something to explain his hunger and to rationalize why a world passes him by without saluting.
And he calls me a jackass. He's a jackass.
The something he looks for and finds is in a sewer.
What I say is what I say.
In his own twisted and distorted lexicon, he calls it faith, strength, truth.
Death, destruction, terrorism, and weakness.
Where will he go next? This phantom from another time, this resurrected ghost of a previous nightmare.
And we are going to make our country great again.
Chicago, Los Angeles, Miami, Florida, Vincennes, Indiana, Syracuse, New York. Any place, every place. Where there's hate, where there's prejudice, where there's bigotry.
They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists.
You brag that you have sexually assaulted women. Do you understand that?
No, I didn't say that at all. I don't think you understood what was said. This was locker room talk.
You call women you don't like fat pigs, dogs, slobs, and disgusting animals.
Do you believe in punishment for abortion? Yes or no? As a principle?
The answer is that there has to be some form of punishment.
For the woman?
Yeah, there has to be some form.
He's alive so long as these evils exist. Remember that when he comes to your town.
I love the old days. You know what they used to do to guys like that when they were in a place like this? They'd be carried out on a stretcher, folks.
They say, I have the most loyal people. Did you ever see that? Where I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody and I wouldn't lose any voters, okay?
Remember it when you hear his voice speaking out through others. Remember it when you hear a name call.
I don't know what I said. I don't remember.
The minority attack.
I want to build a wall. I'm going to build a wall.
I want to build a wall. We need the wall.
And Mexico will pay for the wall.
Any blind, unreasoning assault on a people or any human being.
Would I approve waterboarding? You bet your ass I'd approve it. You bet your ass. In a heartbeat.
And I'd bring back a hell of a lot worse than waterboarding.
I want surveillance of certain mosques, okay?
He's alive because through these things, we keep him alive.
That's a famous Mussolini quote. You retweeted it. You like the quote? Did you know it was
sure.
Mussolini?
It's okay to know it's Mussolini. Look, Mussolini was Mussolini. It's okay to know. It's a very good quote. It's a very interesting quote.
A sickness known as hate. Not a virus, not a microbe, not a germ. But a sickness nonetheless. Highly contagious. Deadly in its effects. Don't look for it in the Twilight Zone. Look for it in the mirror. Look for it before the light goes out altogether.
Is there anybody you'd like to apologize to right now yourself?
No.
The word that Mrs. Bronson is unable to put into the hot, still, sodden air is doomed. Because the people you've just seen have been handed a death sentence. 1 month ago, the Earth suddenly changed its elliptic orbit, and in doing so, began to follow a path which gradually, moment by moment, day by day, took it closer to the sun. And all of man's little devices to stir up the air are no longer luxuries. They happen to be pitiful and panicky keys to survival. The time is 5 minutes to 12, midnight. There is no more darkness. The place is New York City, and this is the eve of the end. Because even at midnight, it's high noon, the hottest day in history, and you're about to spend it in the Twilight Zone.